For the oil-free air compressors, could you maybe kind of talk about what may, how do they differ from those with oil, or maybe what is the benefit of utilizing an oil-free versus
Yeah,
the
absolutely.
alternative?
Yeah, so so for those of you that aren't deep into the compressor industry like I am, it can be a little bit overwhelming to try to decide, what are these terms and what do they mean and stuff like that. The easiest way to think about it is you have two rotary screw, what's called the aerons, which actually compress the air together. And the two different ways that you generally have on that ability is that you can use oil, which is what we term oil flooded. And what the oil does, it has three functions. What it does is it seals the housing between the rotor and the compressor housing. It seals that. It also cools the air because when the air compresses, it gets very, very hot, so it co cools the air, and it also lubricates the bearing. So it has those three main functions. Now, oil free, because it doesn't have anything that any oil within the within the housing, there's a couple of things that does for you. Number one, it makes your outlet air it doesn't have any sort of oil mist or any oil carryover, things like that, things like that. But it also has the drawback of they run hotter. And they don't have they're not as efficient because there's nothing to seal the gap between the housing. So it's very important when you start looking at your which is best for your needs is that you take into account the pros and cons for each. Now, one thing that I do think is going to be very important for your listeners to understand is that every single compressed air application doesn't want oil in the air. Okay. So, it's a matter of how do you achieve that purpose, by the technology and stuff. And I can walk you through the pros and cons to it, but it's important to understand that this oil, for the oil flooded compressor, when it goes downstream, is not like a really nice oil that even if you used it in your application, you don't want it there because it picks up dirt, it picks up pipe scale, it ends up being sludgy. Any sort of valving that that air operates gets, gets gummed up. It, wears on tools. It's just like it creates a lot of havoc. So, no matter which, you can do the same thing with either technology as far as cleaning up the air, so there's no oil in it. But just understand that there's not any real application where you want that oil in there. So it's just how do you go about doing it? Okay. Another thing that most customers are not aware of is that even if you choose an oil-free compressor, you still need to have some sort of cleanup, a cleanup filter on the outside of that compressor. And the reason is because just in the air that we're breathing, the air that you're breathing now, Sarah, the air that I'm breathing, like there is carbon, there's hydrocarbons in the air that we breathe in very minute forms, right? So when you compress it, all of that turns to oil. You still need to get it out. So whatever the compressor sucks into it, it compresses and sends it down the pipe. You still need to filter that. So even if you have an oil-free compressor, you still need to have some filtration downstream to take that out. If you have your compressor next to a loading dock and it's pulling in the fumes from one of the, from a diesel truck, you can bet you're going to have a lot of, a lot of, carbon going downstream that you want to get when you want to get out. So, like I said, there's, I want to make that clear at the very beginning because if you start by, if you start from like, what does my process need, right? Everybody's going to need to have a clean, dry, compressed airstream. And then the technology behind it really is, you really have to start thinking about other things, that might impact your decision instead of just the quality of the air.
Right. So what would maybe then be some applications where an oil-free air compressor would be best suited, or how do you make those decisions on which type to choose?
That's a great question, Sarah. So what we find is that the big difference between the oil-free and the oil-flooded arenas right now is it really comes down to risk, okay? Because what happens is if you have an oil-flooded compressor and you have filters in place to take out the oil in the air, so it can so the air itself can be just as clean. But if you forget to change a filter and that oil gets passed through it, you now have a, you have a risk of that oil getting downstream. So anything that's really high risk to the oil, like it'll like be catastrophic if you start seeing oil, is when you really might want to start thinking about an oil-free compressor. So that would be stuff like we're seeing a lot of these compressors, the oil-free compressors going into food and beverage. We see it going into textiles. We see it going into pharmaceuticals, electronics. The electronic industry is almost all oil-free. Metals, automotive, oil and gas, power, things like that. These are the industries that like they're like, you know what, we're our initial cost really isn't as big of a concern. What we just really can't take the risk of any oil coming downstream to our processes. And that would be a good application to start looking at, an oil-free compressor instead of an oil flooded. And one, the other thing to consider too is we're seeing the industry that even don't have a high risk, if they have a high, if they have a very low tolerance for environmental stuff. So remember, when an oil flooded compressor, you'll get some of that oil that'll bypass. It has to go somewhere. So even if you filter it out, right, it's now combined with the, it's now combined with the, with the moisture that's been in the air and stuff like that, and you can drop it out of your compressor system using dryers, filters. We call it cleanup equipment, right? Because you're cleaning up the air, but you still have to do something with it, right? So where does this water and oil go? Well, you don't want to dump it down the sanitary sewer. That's a big no-no, and rightly so, right? I mean, that has catastrophic impacts for the environment. So what we want to do is we want to take that and either treat it. We have what's called oil water separators that will actually treat the condensate and oil coming from the compressor system, and then dispose of the oil like you would, any of your other waste oil. But the point is that all of that stuff costs money, right? All that stuff takes maintenance. All of those things, are things to consider, because some companies just don't have a good way of doing that. They don't have really good maintenance staff, all these different things. So all these decisions, would really kind of impact, would start impacting your thinking about what, what technology specifically should I be looking at? And so remember, when we started this discussion, when you start looking at the difference between these technologies, right, the oil flooded compressor, even though you have all the environmental concerns of oil, and the cleanup, equipment needed and the maintenance needed to keep those things running smoothly, it's also a lot more efficient, right? So because you've got that oil is closing the distance between the rotor and the housing, it makes the compressor a lot more efficient. You get more airflow out of it. You get it for less input power. So as a customer, you have to be thinking, well, look, if I'm in a up north where I'm paying a massive amount for power, right, well, I'm going to have to pay more to put in an oil, it's not just that an oil-free compressor costs more, right, to begin with. Now my power costs are more. I have to pay more, right? But then on the flip side of that, if you have more cleanup equipment, it creates a pressure drop across this cleanup equipment that your compressor has to overcome. So the reason why, so it sounds like it's a very complicated thing, but what I would encourage your listeners to do is really find somebody that number one, that sells both technologies, right? Because if all you have, if all you have is a hammer, everything looks like a nail, right? So you really want to partner yourself with a compressor expert that says, you know what, I can sell both. So it's really, let me flesh out all these details to make what makes most sense for the customer, and not just what I'm trying to, what I'm just trying to sell, because that's all I have in my, in my bread basket.
Great. Well, thank you so much for taking the time to
Sure.
speak with me today and provide your insights on the technology.